question is, obtain all the zeros of the polynomial x to the power 3x to the power 4 minus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. 3x4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. This is the polynomial, and this polynomial has 4 zeros, maximum 4 zeros. It can have 3 zeros, it can have 2 zeros or 1 zero, 0, 0, 0. But we can expect it can have maximum 4 zeros of power of x is 4. And we have to find out all the zeros of this polynomial. All the zeros are already given. Both the zeros are given as root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3. And our aim is to find out the other two zeros even. That means all the four zeros we write together. Now we form a quadratic polynomial whose two of the zeros are given. We have learned the formula for that. Quadratic polynomial whose zeros are root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3. If a polynomial is given having two zeros, alpha and beta, then we have learned the formula for forming a quadratic polynomial k into x square minus sum of root into x plus product. Using that formula, we form a quadratic polynomial. X square minus, and we can write alpha plus beta, or you can write sum of roots into x plus product of zeros. This is the formula for quadratic polynomial. Four zeros are given, first we'll find out their sum, then we'll find out their product, we substitute the values, and we'll find out the quadratic polynomial whose zeros are this as well as this. We do this a into x square minus. We find out the sum of root 5 by 3 as well as minus root 5 by 3. As well as we try to find out the product, we multiply that. That is root 5 by 3. Into minus root 5 by 3. This is k into x square minus. These are same values, root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3. They are same. Only thing is we have any difference in their sign. And we know that root 5 by 3 minus root 5 by 3 becomes 0. 0 into x. It's a word that x. 0 into x becomes 0 minus. Plus into minus minus, and the product of these two, when you multiply root 5 by 3 and root 5 by 3 two times, the multiplication will be 5 by 3. If you multiply root 5 into root 5, that will be 5. Root sign will be removed because we can write root 5 by 3 whole square, and when you take the square of root 5 by 3, it will become 5 by 3. So just remember, if you are finding the product of two values, same values, then the root has to be root 5 by 3. We take the LCM and we try to simplify it. This is LCM. We got 3x square minus 5. The value of k is not defined. The value of k can be anything. It is actually a constant. Any value of k you can take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, any value. Even you can take some negative value because that is a constant. But for our convenience, we used to take the value of k as the same value whatever is given in the denominator, so that these two will be cancelled and easily you can solve the rest of the part. P and k we have cancelled. For our convenience, we are taking the value of k as 3 and it becomes 3x square minus 5. If 3x square minus 5 is the quadratic polynomial, root 5 by 3 and minus 5 by 3, to find out the other roots, first we'll find out other factor, then we divide.
I'll show you what we have. Suppose I want 18 as a number. One of the factors 18 if I consider as 2. To find out the other factors, we used to divide 18 by 2, 9, 18 factors cancelled. And this is the second factor. 18 has one of the factors 2, then another to find out the other factor, we divide 18 by 2. Same way, a polynomial with degree 4 is given. We know that this could have 4 zeros, maximum 4 zeros. Out of these 4, 2 of the zeros are given. And if these 2 zeros are given, then this polynomial, which is having the zeros root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3, this polynomial will be definitely divide the given polynomial. As 18 has one of the factor 2, the same way this polynomial has one of the factor this. If this polynomial has one factor 2x, 3x square minus 5, to find out the other factors, we divide the whole polynomial px by 3x square minus 5. After that, as in this case, 18 is one of the factors we got to suppose somewhere, we got the factor of 18 as 2. Then we divide 18 by 2 and we got 9. We try to factorize this 9 by some other method. 3 3s are 9 is again possible. Same way we try to do your. After doing this, we write the polynomial 3 to find other factors of px, we divide px by this factor, px to minus 5. We divide this polynomial px by px square minus 5, because px square minus 5 is factor of this polynomial. After dividing it, this 3x4 plus 6x minus 2x square minus 10 is minus 5. One of the factors we got as 3x square minus 5, we divide it. Px4 we require, px4 what is the multiplied, so that we get px4. Already the coefficient is 3, therefore coefficient has not been multiplied. Power of x is here 2, therefore we multiply x square. X square into 3x square is 3x4. X square into minus 5 is minus 5x. We will not write 5x square here, we are writing here. So that the x square will come just below x square. Like terms has to be kept together. We cannot write x square here. X square, if we are writing over here, we cannot subtract. Therefore, when you multiply x square with 3x square, we got 3x square. X square with minus 5, we are multiplying, we are getting minus 5x square. That has to be written in the proper place. Like terms has to be written properly. We change the sign. This is plus, this is minus. Cancel. Next value is 6x cube plus 3x square. Minus 1x minus 5. We have solved minus 2x square and plus 5x square. This is plus 5x square and this is minus 2x square. 5x square minus 2x square is 3x square and we put the sign of the greater value. Greater value is 5, whose sign, new sign is plus. Therefore, we have written plus. You know what I'm talking about the sign working on earlier fact. We will see the new sign. New sign is plus. And plus 5x square minus 2x square is plus 3x square. Now we require 6x cube. Therefore, right here, 2x. 2x into 3x square is 6x cube. 2x into minus 5 is minus 3x. Again, we change the sign. This will become plus, this will become minus. This cancels out. They are same. 6x cube and 6x cube. But the sign is different. Same way, minus 10x and plus 10x are cancelled, so we are having different sign. This is 3x square minus 5. It will go one time. 1 into 3x square, 3x square minus 5. Change the sign, cancel it, because they are exactly the same. Now, x square plus 2x plus 1 is other factor of this polynomial. We try to split the middle term, this quadratic polynomial, and we try to find out the other two zeros, because the biquadratic polynomial has four zeros, two already given, and we were trying to find out two other zeros. Two other zeros we will get from here. Looking at them, because I don't have much space over here, just remember this quotient recon experiment to raise this one. X square plus 2x plus 1. To find other factors or other zeros, we factorize x square plus 2x plus 1 because this is the quotient recon. Try to factorize the quotient using Spredinger middle term. Why we use Spredinger middle term? Because the power of x is 2 and the quadratic polynomial has one of the method to factorize is to Spredinger middle term. X square plus 2x plus 1. This can be taken as 0. To find out the roots of the polynomial, we used to take the polynomial itself as 0. So you have x square plus x plus x plus y equal to 0. For the factorization, for the multiplication of first and the last term, we got plus 1. We take all the factors as 1. 1 ones are 1 and 1 ones are 1. Besides, we have plus, so if we choose two values whose addition is equal to 2. One number is 1, other number is 1 ones are 1. Then we take 1x and 1x. Usually we don't write 1x, we used to write x and x only. We try to take common now from these two x is common, we got x plus 1. From these two again, we are trying to take common, nothing is common, that means 1 is common, x plus 1. These two brackets should be always same. If the brackets are not same somewhere here, you have mistaken. Here we are giving these two brackets same, x plus 1 equal to 0. The product of these two is 0, that means either x plus 1 is 0 or x plus 1 equal to 0. So this is 0 or this is 0. 0 then x equal to minus 1. And if this is 0, then x equal to minus 1. Therefore, two other zeros we got minus 1 and minus 1. Now just concentrate on the top line of the question. Here the question is operate all zeros. Half mark will be deducted if you are not writing the all the zeros. Therefore, make sure you read the question properly and accordingly you are writing the answer. Operate all the zeros of this polynomial. Two of the zeros are already given. Two more zeros we got only as it is. You write, therefore, all the zeros of the given polynomial are root 5 by 3, minus root 5 by 3, minus 5, as well as minus 1. Therefore, these are the four zeros of the polynomial x. At last, write all the four zeros. Therefore, zeros of px are root 5 by 3, this was given, minus root 5 by 3, this was also given, and just now we have calculated two more zeros, minus 1, as well as 1. All the four zeros has to be written together. There is mark for this, half mark will be given this. Expecting you understood that, once again, let me explain the question. Polynomial was given, two of the zeros were given. With the help of the formula k into x square minus sum of root into x plus product of z roots, we try to find out the polynomial. We got it as px square minus 5. There is another way to do that. As you can write x minus alpha into x minus beta. Steps will be 4, that's why I haven't shown this. X minus alpha is 2. Root 5 by 3, first one we got root 5 by 3, second we got minus of plus root 5 by 3, and you multiply it, this will be x square minus 5 by 3, a used to get a, after taking an exercise, the same thing again. I have avoided this method, I am shown by this method. If you are in practice with this method, then you can do, but I think this will be the easy one by directly finding. The formula k into x square minus sum of root into x plus product.
That's are shown in that way.
Once we got the polynomial whose roots are 5 by 3 and minus 5 by 3, divide this given polynomial by this one.
In this case, we are getting x squared plus 2x plus 1.
As I said, if one factor of a is 2, find out the other factors we use to factorize 9 further. Same way, if the given polynomial px has one of the factors px squared minus 5, find out the other factors before they divide the given polynomial by px squared minus 5. We got the quotient as x squared plus 2x plus 1.
Try to factorize x squared plus 2x plus 1 by splitting the middle term. We got x plus 1, or x equal to minus 1, minus 1 are the other two zeros.
All the four zeros have to be written together because the question is same. Expecting that this question you understood, this is a very important question, and it used to come in the examination, in board examination, more often the question used to come.
Therefore, you have to practice it.
Next one is, divide the polynomial. Px equal to 2x cubed minus plus 3x squared minus 11x minus 6 by x plus 3 and verify the division algorithm.
Part is to find out the division. Division as I've shown earlier, the same way you have to find out the division. The division algorithm also later on. What do you mean, this
division algorithm? 2x cubed plus 3x squared minus 7x minus 6 has to be divided by x plus 3. Since we are trying to divide this polynomial by x plus 3, it was titled descending power of the variable, that is the standard form of the dividend as well as divisor has to be. If in question it would have given 3 plus x, then we first write the polynomial of the value which is having greater power. X has to be first, 3 has to be later on. The same way, the dividend has also to be written in standard form. After that, we see the first term. Here the first term is 2x cubed. Here the first term is x. In column, divide the first term of dividend by the first term of x. First term of divisor.
2x cubed divided by x.
2x cubed upon x is 2x cubed. Then 2x cubed. Right here, 2x squared. 2x squared into x is 2x cubed. 2x squared into 3 is 6x squared, and 6x squared. 2, 3 is 6x. Do the proper multiplication. 2x squared into x is 2x cubed. 2x squared into 3 is 6x squared. We have just written below x squared. Like terms are to put together. Change the sign. Don't forget to change the sign. If it is plus, then you write minus. If it is plus, you write minus. If it is
plus, then minus, then it's just opposite sign. Because while subtraction, we used to change the sign.
First value will be always cancelled.
And every time you cancel the first term, which is
necessary, cancel the first two values.
You should get zero, otherwise the process of division will not be done properly.
Then do the subtraction. Here this is 3x squared minus 6x squared.
Yeah, like terms.
Having the power of x as 2 in each of the case. And 6 minus 3. One is having minus 1, other side is having plus, therefore.
We have to do the subtraction, and 6 minus 3 is 3.
We have to put the sign of the greater value, greater value is 6 square, which is new sign as minus that we are adding on the face. Minus 11x, minus 6, other value must be copy fast.
To avoid confusion, copy all the terms as it is. Now, we require a minus 3x square.
First, you multiply to this
x so that you get minus 3x squared.
That is minus 3x. Minus 3x into x is minus 3x squared. Minus 3x into 3 is
minus 9x.
We'll write here minus 9x. Change the sign, this has become plus, and this is cancelled. Minus 11x plus 9x is minus 2x minus 6. Here we got x,
we require minus 2x.
If we write here, minus 2 into x is minus 2x, minus 2 into plus a is minus 6. Change the sign, this is plus, and this is plus, this is cancelled, this is cancelled. The remainder we got as 0.
After getting the remainder, the first part of the question to divide the polynomial
by polynomial x plus 3. Second part is verify the division algorithm.
To verify the division algorithm, we got two parts. The first is show that dividend equal to divisor in the quotient plus remainder, and second is degree of remainder is always less than the degree of divisor.
Let me show the division algorithm. At least one of the part I will show. I'll write everything in one of the part of again takes space. We have the dividend as 2x3 plus 3x² minus 11x minus 6.
The number which is divided is known as dividend, and that is equal to this one.
2x plus 3x²
minus 11x minus 6.
And this is divided by, that is, x plus 3.
X plus 3 is the divisor. After dividing it,
we got the quotient as 2x² minus 3x minus 2. 2x² minus 3x minus 2.
This is the quotient.
And we got the remainder as once we got all these values, we try to verify the division algorithm. Verification.
To do the verification,
we first actually the division algorithm is division algorithm
is dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder.
This is the first part, and the second part is degree of remainder is less than degree of divisor.
So both these parts has to be verified.
To verify this, we take the first part. We multiply divisor as well as quotient. If the multiplication of these two plus remainder is equal to dividend, then it is verified. Divisor into quotient plus remainder. You have to find out this,
and we'll check it whether it is equal to dividend or not. It's the first part actually.
Divisor we got as x plus 3. Quotient we got as 2x² minus 3x minus 2, and the remainder we got 0.
Put the values as it is. And once if you got all these values multiplied,
x in mostly multiplying x with 2x² minus 3x minus 2. And after that we multiply 3 with 2x² minus 3x minus 2. This is 2x³ minus 3x² minus 2x plus 6x² minus 6x minus 6 plus 0.
Add the like terms and check whether it is equal to the dividend or not.
2x³, that's the only term which is having the variable x³. that as x cube minus 3x square plus 6x square, they are like terms. And the addition of these two, one is plus, other is minus, the addition is called as plus 3x square. Minus 2x minus 6x minus 8x minus 8x. But here we are getting minus 3, so this is a 9. This is a 9. 9x minus 2x, this is minus 11x. And we got minus 6, which is equal to the dividend. Therefore, the first part is verified. We have multiplied dividend. We got dividend equal to divide by quotient remainder. We have started with divide by quotient remainder. After that, we got equal to the dividend. Therefore, the first part is verified. To verify the second part, we see the degree of remainder. Remainder is 0. Here, this is smaller than divisor. Divisor is degree. Either you will get 0, and if it is not equal to 0, then the degree of remainder will be less than the degree of divisor. Here we want 0, therefore we don't have to check it. This is the second type of question which used to come in the examination. Very important question. You have to practice it. Particularly, I have taken these two questions because these are important questions. Last time we had not enough time to do these type of questions. Therefore, I have taken one more class for this particular topic. We can start the new topic from the next day onwards. Come in time. Most of you are not coming in proper time and coming to the class very late. I cannot admit you. Thank you. And if you are having any queries, we will